Good morning, class 3. Now today we will be doing the next part of the lesson, The Pencil That Ran Away. We'll be reading page 66 and 67 and 68. Now till now you have understood the lesson well, that there was a pencil and that pencil is talking about herself, that I am a pencil, I am yellow in color, I stayed in a shop, in a stationery shop, and I have a family also, and my parents tell me not to move from the shelves, otherwise you will be lost. But still I managed to slip from the shelf, and one of the girls, Sarah, she picked me up and she bought me from the shopkeeper. Till now you have read about the lesson. Up till now, this is the story you have read. And she was picked up by Sarah. Sarah was a girl who was wearing a yellow frock, and the girl and the pencil was also yellow in color. Now let's read the next paragraph. Now began my new life. Her new life started. Why? Because she was picked up by Sarah and she went to Sarah's house. I was made much of by Sarah, who promptly put me in her pencil box with two other pencils. Now the moment she bought me, she put me in her pencil box, and there were two more pencils, and there was a sharpener and an eraser and a ruler. The sharpener was moody. The pencils were angry that Sarah had a new favorite, and the eraser and the ruler were quiet and said nothing. I was already missing my mother's love and a warning which I had not heeded. I missed my brothers and sisters, she says, the pencil says. I was missing my mother's love because I was picked up by Sarah and she bought me and she took me home, and I was missing my mother. And I was missing a warning which I never paid attention to, which I never listened. Heeded means listen. And I miss my brothers and sisters also. Now I had new companions, new friends. There were two angry pencils, one eraser and one and a ruler in that geometry box, in her pencil box. Sarah sat down at her table to write her composition. She started writing a paragraph. I was brought out of the pencil box. Mereko nikala gaya pencil box se bahar. Admired. Meri tarif ki gayi. Khush hui. Sara mereko dekhe. And then began my troubles. Phir meri trouble shuru hui. I was sharpened for the first time. Aap bhi karte ho. When you start writing, you start sharpening your pencil. You make it more sharp. Then again you will sharp. I was sharpened for the first time, and the pain was unbearable. First time when she sharpened me, it was such an unbearable pain. Aapko koi sharp kare to aapko kaisa lagega? Similarly, the pencil also felt very painful when she was sharp for the first time. When Sarah was satisfied, jab woh satisfied ho gayi, that I was sharp enough, main bahut sharp hoon, she put me to work. उसने मेरे को काम पे चालू कर दिया, लगा दिया. आई हैड टू राइट नियरली 3 pages, एंड समटाइम्स सारा वुड इरेज वॉट शी हैड रिटन एंड स्टार्ट ऑल ओवर अगेन. शी रोट 3 pages ऑफ कॉम्पोजिशन, एंड शी रब्ड ऑल्सो, एंड शी रोट अगेन एंड अगेन. आई वॉज पुट ऑन द पेपर अगेन एंड अगेन. आई वर्क वेरी हार्ड फॉर सारा. दैट इज वॉट पेंसिल इज टॉकिंग. नाउ दिस स्टोरी इज अबाउट द पेंसिल हु इज नरेटिंग हर स्टोरी. पेंसिल अपनी खुद स्टोरी नरेट कर रही. सो आई वॉज पुट टू वर्क अगेन एंड अगेन. ठीक है. सारा वुड रेज. ओके. वेन शी पुट मी बैक इन द बॉक्स, आई वॉज सो टायर्ड दैट आई फॉल अस्लीप एट वंस. जैसे ही उसने मेरे को बॉक्स में वापस रखा, फिर मैं सो गई. किसने बोला ये? पेंसिल ने बोला. After a week, I felt I could not put up with this life anymore. Now, after 1 week, I said, this is very strange. If this is the way she would be using me, एंड आई विल बी नो वेयर, मैं तो ख़त्म हो जाऊँगी, आई विल बी फिनिश्ड, शी विल बी जस्ट शार्पनिंग मी, शी विल बी जस्ट पुटिंग मी ऑन द पेंसिल ऑन द नोटबुक एंड आई विल बी फिनिश्ड. आई वॉज रिड्यूस टू हाफ माई साइज, कितनी हो गई थी मैं, हाफ हो गई थी. देखो पेंसिल बोल रही है, आई वॉज रिड्यूस टू हाफ माई साइज एंड आई थॉट आई वुड डिसअपियर इफ आई स्टेड देयर एनी लॉन्ग. शी सेज आई थॉट आई वुड डिसअपियर, मैं डिसअपियर ही हो जाऊँगी इफ आई स्टेड देयर एनी लॉन्गर, इतनी देर अगर मैं सारा के पास रही तो आई वुड बी डिसअपियर्ड. हेंस आई डिसाइडेड टू रन अवे, सो आई थॉट आई वुड रन अवे. One morning when Sara forgot to put me back in the pencil box, I jumped down from the table. I jumped from the pencil box and I went down the stairs and I ran away. It was wonderful to be out in the garden. She says, it was wonderful to be out in the garden. बहुत अच्छा लगा मेरे को गार्डन में आके. Among the trees, the flowers, the birds and the squirrels. The sun felt warm and nice and I sat down for a moment to catch my breath. I just ran away from the pencil box and I felt that fresh air of the garden and I felt nice and I had a sigh of relief. मैंने एक सांस लिया, ठीक है. I looked around and saw a tiny squirrel running to and fro. थोड़ी देर मैंने जब देखा तो एक छोटी सी स्क्विरल कभी ऊपर जा रही है, कभी नीचे आ रही है, कभी ऊपर जा रही है, कभी नीचे जा रही है. आई कॉल्ड आउट, विल यू प्ले विद मी, उसने बोला क्या तुम मेरे साथ खेलोगी. द स्क्विरल स्टॉप्ड एंड लुक्ड एट मी. आई एम सो सॉरी, आई हैव नो टाइम टू स्पेयर. शी सेज आई एम सॉरी, आई एम बिजी, आई कैन नॉट प्ले विद यू. आई एम बिजी कलेक्टिंग नट्स फॉर द विंटर. शी सेज आई एम बिजी कलेक्टिंग नट्स फॉर द विंटर. मैं क्या कर रही हूँ, मैं नट्स कलेक्ट कर रही हूँ विंटर के लिए. क्यों, आपको पता है स्क्विरल क्या करती हैं, स्क्विरल गिलहरियाँ वो नट्स बादाम इकट्ठे करती हैं, नट्स इकट्ठे करती हैं और वो सर्दियों में हाइबरनेट हो जाती हैं. हाइबरनेट मतलब ज़मीन के अंदर चली जाती है और जब वो ज़मीन के अंदर चली जाती हैं तो फिर वो हाइबरनेट ही रहती हैं पूरी फुल विंटर्स, बिकॉज इन विंटर्स इट इज़ वेरी कोल्ड. सो दे कलेक्ट देयर फूड एंड दे गो इन साइड द अर्थ एंड दे रिमेन देयर for some months till the winter is over. I will show you the hibernation pictures after this video if you continue listening to the video, okay. And so saying the squirrel was off again. So squirrel went away without giving me a second glance. मतलब second time उसने मेरे को देखा भी नहीं और वो चली गई. Let me ask those butterflies. She says I'll ask these butterflies. Thought I and I turned to a blue butterfly that was fluttering above the roses. वो roses के ऊपर flutter कर रही थी. आपने flutter word पढ़ा था, flutter means फड़फड़ाना, flutter कर रही थी. Come play with me for some time. She says come play with me for some time. I feel lonely, said I. Looking at the butterfly hopefully. Then the pencil, she looked at the butterfly and she offered her, let us play. I'm feeling very bored, I'm lonely. The butterfly was fluttering on the roses. The butterfly only flapped its pretty wings harder. No time to play, I have to work. She says, I don't have any time to play. I have a lot of work. I now saw a parrot perched on an apple tree. अभी मैंने क्या देखा? एक parrot जो perched down. Perch means ऊपर जा रहा है apple tree के. She was watching me and pecking at the juicy fruit too. That parrot was watching her and he was pecking. Pecking मतलब peck करना, juicy fruit के ऊपर चोंच मारना, pecking. He was pecking at the juicy fruit. Pecking and hibernation मैं आपको इसके इस chapter के बाद आपको video में दिखाऊंगी, okay? So turning her head away, she said, I have to feed my little babies. You are hungry and waiting for me. She says, sorry, I can't play with you. मेरे को अपने छोटे छोटे बच्चों को खाना खिलाना है. हाँ, and she flew away before I could say anything anymore. The oak tree under whose shade I was resting shook its branches and said. Then he says, the pencil was actually under the oak tree. OAK, oak is a kind of a tree. And we cannot play all the time. We have work to do. I was resting under the oak tree, and the oak tree also said the same thing, that I cannot play all the time. We have work to do, and we have to do it well. I have to give shade. The apple tree has to give fruit. The squirrel has to store nuts for the winter, and the parrot has to look after her little ones. The oak tree told her, look, I also cannot play. If you tell me to play with you, I cannot play. I have to give you shade. Main tumko chhaya dena chahta hu. Main tumko chhaya de raha hu. Because I have work to do. Then the parrot has to feed her babies. The apple tree has to give fruits. And the squirrel has to store nuts for the winter. So everybody has work. Nobody is free like you. So the oak tree told her. Then what happened? The pencil realized it was true. Ye to theek tha. I could not escape from work. मैं वर्क से भाग नहीं सकती हूँ. जो मेरा काम है वो मेरे को करना है. लेट मी रेस्ट फॉर अ वाइल नाउ, थॉट आई एंड स्ट्रेच माई सेल्फ अंडर द ट्री. शी सेज, मैं थोड़ी देर रेस्ट करके एंड आई विल ऑल्सो गो एंड वर्क फॉर सारा. सारा एंड अ फ्रेंड सैम वर प्लकिंग रोजेस फॉर हर मदर व्हेन सडनली दे सॉ मी अंडर द ट्री. दे वर प्लकिंग सारा एंड अ फ्रेंड दे वर प्लकिंग रोजेस फ्रॉम द ट्री एंड सडनली दे सॉ मी. सडनली उन्होंने मेरे को देखा. माई गुडनेस सारा, Isn't that the pencil you were searching for this morning? I said, my goodness, Sarah. Sarah, listen. Isn't that the pencil you were searching for this morning? Her friend says, आप तुम इसी को search कर रहे थे ना? How did it come here? ये कैसे यहाँ पे आई है? It surprises me too, said Sarah. I don't remember bringing it to the garden at all. It surprises me too. उसने बोला मेरे को भी सरप्राइज हो रहा है. सारा ने बोला आई डोंट रिमेंबर, मैं तो उसको गार्डन में लेके नहीं आई. आई वॉज पिक्ड अप एंड सून पुट बैक इन टू द पेंसिल बॉक्स. आई वॉज पिक्ड अप बाई सारा एंड आई वॉज पुट अप इन द पेंसिल बॉक्स. बट नाउ आई वॉज डिटर्मिंड टू डू माई वर्क विदाउट बींग लेजी. देन द पेंसिल सेड दैट आई वॉज डिटर्मिंड दैट आई विल वर्क फॉर सारा एंड आई विल नॉट जस्ट रन अवे फ्रॉम द पेंसिल बॉक्स बिकॉज माई ड्यूटी इज टू वर्क फॉर सारा. And Sarah started doing her homework. She was amazed at the way her pencil flew over the paper and her work was finished so soon that she could not believe it. The moment Sarah started writing with a pencil, she was amazed to see how fast the pencil was running because the pencil was determined to work for Sarah. And she realized that it is her work. She cannot just do away without her work. She cannot just leave her work. अपने काम को छोड़ के रह नहीं सकेगी. ठीक है, बिकॉज एवरीबडी हैज़ टू वर्क फॉर देयर लाइवलीहुड, फॉर देयर एवरीबडी हैज़ टू फुलफिल देयर ड्यूटीज. वॉट अ स्मार्ट पेंसिल आई हैव, सारा रियलाइज्ड. एक्सक्लेम शी, आई वुडंट एक्सचेंज इट फॉर द बेस्ट पेंसिल इन द वर्ल्ड. शी सेज आई वुड नेवर द बेस्ट पेंसिल, शी इज द बेस्ट पेंसिल फॉर मी. एंड देन The next time you find your pencil lying in the garden, you know why it has run away? Treat it properly and take good care of it. You don't want to lose it, do you? So the next time, whenever you lose your pencil in the garden, you must treat it properly and take good care of it.